This unit, we're going to talk about poetry and figurative language. The two go hand in hand, and you'll find out soon how they do. First, let's define poetry. Poetry is a literary work in which special intensity is given to the expression of feelings and ideas by the use of distinctive style and rhythm, poems collectively or as a genre of literature. What does that mean? Well, it means that text is used to convey emotion and feelings and pictures through words. We're going to watch a clip from Dead Poets Society explaining poetry.
Gentlemen, open your text, page 21 of the introduction. Mr. Perry, will you read the opening paragraph of the preface entitled Understanding Poetry?
Understanding Poetry by Dr. J. Evans Pritchard, PhD. To fully understand poetry, we must first be fluent with its meter, rhyme, and figures of speech, then ask two questions. One, how artfully has the objective of the poem been rendered? And two, how important is that objective? Question one rates the poem's perfection. Question two rates its importance. And once these questions have been answered, determining the poem's greatness becomes a relatively simple matter. If the poem's score for perfection is plotted on the horizontal of a graph, and its importance is plotted on the vertical, then calculating the total area of the poem yields the measure of its greatness. A sonnet by Byron might score high on the vertical, but only average on the horizontal. A Shakespearean sonnet, on the other hand, would score high both horizontally and vertically, yielding a massive total area, thereby revealing the poem to be truly great. As you proceed through the poetry in this book, practice this rating method. As your ability to evaluate poems in this manner grows, so will your enjoyment and understanding of poetry.
Excellent. That's what I think of Mr. J. Evans Pritchard. We're not lighting pipe. We're talking about poetry. How could you describe poetry like American Bandstand? Well, I like Byron. I give him a 42, but I can't dance to it. Now, I want you to rip out that page. So you are. Excuse me.
So basically, what they mean is that poetry isn't something that you can rate on a scale. It isn't something that you can determine the greatness, because whether you like a poem is based on your experiences and how you feel about a particular subject. So poetry is text that's full of feeling and ideas with style and rhythm. And what is rhythm? Well, that's a good question. Rhythm is a literary device that demonstrates the long and short patterns through stressed and unstressed syllables, particularly in verse form, which basically means the beat and flow of text. So rhythm can be found different places. It can be found in nature. It can be found human-made. It can be found by clapping your hands. It can be found banging on a drum. We're going to listen to two different kinds of rhythm. First, Queen, and We Will Rock You.
Big disgrace, kicking your industry, you gonna take all the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
Oops. Next, we're going to listen to Tchaikovsky's 1812 Overture. Now, I want you to keep in mind the rhythm that we just heard with Queen and see if you can find the rhythm in Tchaikovsky. Now, if you hear the difference, the rhythm in Tchaikovsky changes throughout the song. Queen pretty much stayed the same. And that's how poetry can work, too. Rhythm can change throughout the text. How else do you think you can make rhythm? Can you make rhythm with your body? With objects? Do you think words can make rhythm? Here's an example of words making rhythm.
Home when you look,
you're right.
Your daddy was home when you look,
you're right.
Your sister was home when you look,
you're right.
Your brother was home when you look,
you're right.
Your dog was home when you look,
you're right.
Your cat was home when you look,
you're right.
Your fish was home when you look,
you're right.
Your mommy, your daddy, your brother, your sister, the dog, the cat, the fish was home when you look,
you're right.
And that's the reason you look,
you're right.
I left my home.
I left my home.
Johnny Arnett.
So now we're going to turn off the video and we're going to make our own rhythm and experiment with different kinds of rhythm.